Professor Dave and Chegg here. While valence bond theory is an important model for describing covalent bonding, we will sometimes want to use molecular orbital theory as well, as this is a very successful model for describing organic molecules. Let's go over some aspects of this theory that will be the most relevant to us.
Molecular orbital theory involves the mathematical combinations of atomic orbitals to form molecular orbitals which belong to the entire molecule rather than a single atom, which is the case for the familiar hybrid atomic orbitals. But like any other type of orbital, these molecular orbitals describe regions in space where electrons can be found. So how precisely does this combination occur? Well, we know that each electron can be described by a wave function. When we combine two waves, they can either line up so as to give constructive interference, where the peaks and troughs double to result in a wave with up to twice the amplitude, or they can give destructive interference, where every point on the wave cancels with the point on the other wave to result in a wave with as little as zero amplitude. This applies to orbitals because electrons are three-dimensional waves that combine with in-phase waves to produce regions with a high probability of electron density, as well as out-of-phase waves to produce regions of no electron density, which we call nodes. When the two 1s orbitals from two hydrogen atoms overlap to form a hydrogen molecule, they will produce two molecular orbitals. The in-phase combination produces a lower energy sigma s bonding orbital. The out-of-phase combination, which essentially subtracts the wave functions, produces a higher energy sigma s star antibonding orbital, which has a node between the nuclei. Electrons will occupy the lowest energy orbital available, which is why the two electrons in this bond will reside in the bonding orbital. Looking at p orbitals, each p orbital has two lobes with opposite phases. When lobes of the same phase overlap, which here are represented by the same color, we get constructive interference, which makes a larger region of probability density. When lobes of opposite phase overlap, it's destructive interference, and we get a node and an antibonding orbital. If two p orbitals have lateral overlap rather than direct overlap, they generate pi orbitals. If they overlap in phase, it's the pi orbital, which is a bonding orbital. If they overlap out of phase, it's the pi star orbital, which is an antibonding orbital, and there is a node between the nuclei, meaning electrons cannot be shared between them. The two electrons in the pi bond will inhabit the bonding orbital, and the antibonding orbital will be unoccupied in the ground state electron configuration.
Molecular orbital theory is tremendously useful for describing more complex molecules, like those that have extensive systems of pi bonds, as the delocalization of electron density makes more sense to describe using molecular orbitals that pertain to the entire molecule as a whole. But we will describe these situations when they become relevant. Professor Dave for Chegg. See you next time.